So talk about that. Talk about how this is really a homecoming for you, because you said you never got to say goodbye, because you left.
I went away.
You became a Hollywood star.
Well, thanks to PBS, who started broadcasting Qué Pasa USA nationally. Mm-hmm. So I'm in college doing theater, mm-hmm. and I'm doing this little show, Qué Pasa USA, which has already become a sensation on the local station,
sure.
on PBT. So I'm getting, like, you know, response everywhere I go in town, mm-hmm. right? And I went from being, like, the shyest boy to a local celebrity, right? And I'd just been acting for, like, 2 years. That's it. When I did Qué Pasa USA. And I never was that sure that it was working, other than the fact that our fans loved us. Mm-hmm. Loved every episode and every moment, and it was beautifully written and beautifully acted, executed, and the director was Bernard Lechowick, and he was from LA, and he was a perfectionist, bless his heart, because it's great. When you watch the episodes, the way it's executed is so good. The comedy is so good. Just me as a fan, as a drama critic, mm-hmm. and as a television critic, in contrasting everything I saw in LA and what was on TV then, and you know, the statement from the fans to me that was so, like, irritating at times, which was, why aren't you doing more episodes?
Yeah.
Or why can't this, you know, be recognized, you know? Or this is so much better than the programming on network television.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
And I just had no answers for that. Mm-hmm. And I had gone to LA, so I'm now part of that crowd who's making those, you know, kind of cheesy, you know, easy comedy shows. They were going through the roof, mm-hmm. at the time, and I knew that what we had was special, but I couldn't go back to it. It was over.
Wow.
Yeah.
But you missed it, right?
Of course, I missed it. I missed the people.
Yeah.
I missed the people, and I missed Miami. And to come home now, to get this opportunity to tell our story, what happened to our lives over the last 40 years. Remember, I was 14 then. And it's really, for me, one of the high points of not only my career, but my life, because I get some closure at last. And I had no way to plan it. I had no way to wish for it to happen. It just happened because of certain people, namely Nelson, the producer, who had a dream. And he was much, much younger when he first saw it. He was a boy. But he was in contact, and he was aware of the fervor, the tremendous passion that was associated with this show that was no more. And it's like the Beatles. I mean, it lasts. It's on record, but it's only that much.
Sure.
And all the people that wished for more will never get more. And Qué Pasa USA, there was no way to get more, because it was done and we were disbanded.
Yeah. What has it been like for you to not only come back to Miami, but to see your fellow actors? You've gotten to hang out now again with Barbara Ann and with Connie, and you told me you saw Anna Margot, and how emotional that's been for you. What's it been like reconnecting with them?
Well, if you see me get emotional now, imagine being around them. I mean, the girls, you know, I call them the girls because those are my girls. They mm-hmm. were my sisters, and they're still here. And to be able to be on stage with them is it's so many things at once emotionally, because it throws me back to being 18.
Really?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. I am myself at 18 when I'm there, but I am also the accumulation of experience of a man, becoming a man, and being, it's almost schizophrenic because we're reliving the connection.
Yeah.
When we talk to each other on stage, we don't have to act. We don't have to create a character. I mean, I don't. I certainly don't. And I know that most of them feel just about the same. I have never lost Joe. Mm. For me, I don't have to invent a Joe. Mm-hmm. Joe Pena. Joe is me. Mm. And Joe, you know, never lived what I did. He never got to. But I did.
Yeah.
And what the writer has written is the story of what happens to Joe and Violeta and Carmencita and Sharon.
Because it's Que Pase USA 40
years later.
Que
Pase USA today.
Today. So today. Here you are. You said Joe was really you. And so here you are. You're a father. Yeah. You get to bring all of that to the stage. Mm. How has that been in rehearsal?
It's just, like I said, it's easy. It's very, very gratifying. I feel like I've been given this amazing gift, so that going to work, it doesn't even make sense to me. It has very little to do with work. It is an opportunity to feel love and to have my heart just pounded and opened up and filled with incoming love. Mm-hmm. And I can't, I'm trying not to get ahead of myself, because opening night, I just saw the theater for the first time. Opening night, to be there with knowing who those people are out there, I hope I can keep it together. I hope I'm professional enough and I've learned and my instrument is tuned enough where I can, just take a deep breath and, you know, and be Joe 40 years later and just forget where we are and what we're doing and what we're bringing to an audience that has waited 40 years.
Because this just isn't any audience. This is Miami. These are your peeps.
Some of them have been waiting 40 yeah. years, and they bought tickets right away because those are the ones that have been bugging me over the years every time I come here yeah. and say, you know what, you should do more episodes of that show. I'm like, oh my gosh, uh-huh. oh, come on. I mean, don't you know? They right. don't know.
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, I can't do that. Mm-hmm. I can't do it. But lo and behold, I found somebody who could.
Yeah.
Who wanted to, who dreamed of it.
Yeah.
Nelson Alvarez, he just dreamed it up and had the passion, and he found the right, you know, writer and director, Gonzalo Rodriguez. And Gonzalo is what a great stage director. Yeah. I want to do some more plays, you know.
Yeah, you like the live audience?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I haven't done it in 20 some years. The last time was in a stage play, a play called Bent, which is a really, really hard play to do. And I played the lead, and it's a Holocaust play. And but it was in LA, you know, and it was sold out every night. But it was in a theater that was this big.
Yeah. not mean, like the Arts Center.
Not that big.
Yeah.
So I really, I loved it every night. And that was work because I had to create a character that had nothing to do with me. Mm. You know, it's a character that lived, you know, 70 years ago. To do this now is something I have dreamed of, but I never thought it would be Kevasi Jose.
Really?
I thought of doing, you know, I thought I was going to do a Broadway play, or, you know, I've done an, actually I did an off-Broadway show with John Malkovich in New York City in 85, but that's 23 years ago.
Yeah. So did you ever hesitate when Nelson came to you to do this? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What was your first thought?
You can't make it happen. Mm. You can't, and if you make it happen, how can it be great? I mean, how do you hold it up in comparison to the original? What can you do to make the story new without the original writer on board? And so my questions and my resistance had to do with who's doing it besides the girls? They need a script. You know, and if I'm part of it, you know, it's just us with an audience that's been waiting 40 years. So it's got to be great. It can't be okay.
Yeah.
And that was my whole feeling was I'll get in only if I know that it's going to be great. I'm not going to do something in Miami and do something on stage and do something for this audience that people will walk out and go, oh, that was cute.
But no. Not, yeah.
No.
The show
no,
was so man. Great because it was so funny and so poignant and spot on. I had a friend recently tell me, she says, that was my family. That is my family. We still speak Spanglish. We still mess around. We still miscommunicate with each other, you know? So that's why, do you think that's why it's so timely? Because people are still living that way today.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Everything's changed, but nothing's changed in how we relate to each other. The fact that we are still here, and I mean here on Earth, that generation and the generation before that is just fading and is dying away, and our children are still like us. Mm-hmm. We're still like us. We have sophisticated. We have, you know, grown and added elements to our personality, and we also have accumulated, you know, a lot of stuff, tragedies and just bad stuff. But those of us who are still here are the same, and so. There are thousands that are like us, at least thousands. That's just Miami. Mm-hmm. And this show, it will offer them a mirror of who they are. Mm-hmm. If I was in the audience, I would say, I want to see us mm-hmm. again. Mm-hmm. Because we haven't had it in 40 years. We haven't had another show. And the cool thing is that instead of it being an announcement of shooting or a TV series that people are going to have to wait to see in its entirety, and you won't know the response until, you know, it plays for a few weeks. Well, all that stuff, which is what we always thought would happen if someone had the guts to do it and the wherewithal, the money to do it. Instead, he chose to do it on stage in live performances. And it's a limited run. It's 9 performances. And come, you know, it come and see it while it's here. But if you miss it, we're not going away forever again. I feel strongly that this union, this collaboration, is going to have legs.
So you've heard it here.
Say.
It's going to have legs. This isn't it.
This isn't it. This isn't it. By any, not as far as I'm concerned. You know, I didn't come here. It was a one-shot deal, to just, you know, sow my oats and, you know, my stomping grounds again. That wasn't my objective. My objective was to come home and to start giving a little bit back. And this show does it. And I have full confidence now because I've watched the rehearsals. My part is, it's limited. You'll see. But the girls and the rest of the ensemble carry it. They carry it and they're entertaining. It's entertaining and it's sad and it's beautiful and it's melodic. And I watched the last few rehearsals and I was just full of confidence now because I don't have to say, well, I know my part's good. It's going to be good. I'm going to be damn sure that I'm going to deliver. Mm-hmm. And my partner she's great, you know, Connie. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to give away the story, but she is a powerhouse. But you know, that's just my part.
Yeah.
I didn't know that they were so great, and director Gonzalo has just done a great job with them. He's a taskmaster. And I'm sure they all probably hated him for a while, but he's really happy now, and so are we all.
We're in for a good show.
Because we're ready to go.
So you're happy.
I'm happy. I'm happy. I'm, you know, I have to keep it, you know, under control, you know, keep the throttle down, because once, you know, Thursday happens, I'm gonna be going, and I won't stop until our last performance, and then we'll start planning the rest.
Phase two.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So great to
Thanks
talk
for
to
the
you.
Opportunity. Thank yeah. you for the opportunity to tell my story.
Best of luck with the show.
And tell the story of Que Pasa.
Our pleasure.
All right.